10-11, we have a picture. We see the Earth right in the center of the screen, over.
Roger, Houston, Apollo 11. Calling in from about 130,000 miles out. And we'll zoom our camera in slowly to get the most magnification we can, over.
Roger. Houston, the definition is pretty good on our monitor here. The color's not too varsity, at least on this set. Could you describe what you're looking at, over?
Roger, you're seeing Earth as we see it at our left-hand window, just a little more than a half Earth. We're looking at the eastern Pacific Ocean, and the north half of the top half of the screen, we can see North America, Alaska, United States, Canada, Mexico, and Central America. South America becomes invisible just off beyond the terminator or inside the shadow. We can see the oceans with a definite blue cast. See white bands of major cloud formations across the Earth, and can see coastlines. Pick out the western U.S., San Joaquin Valley, the Sierra Mountain Range, the peninsula of Baja California, and can see some cloud formations over southeastern U.S. There's one definite mild storm southwest of Alaska. Looks like about 500 to 1,000 miles. And another very minor storm showing the south end of the screen near the, a long way south of the equator, probably 45 degrees or more south latitude. Can pick out the ground, the browns in the landforms pretty well. The greens do not show up very well. Some green showing along the northwestern coast of the United States and northwestern coast of Canada.
Roger, 11. It's a pretty good picture on clarity here. We're having, could you tell us, it appears to us that there are two distinct cloud formations trending east-west, one approximately about along the equator and one around 30 or so south latitude. Could you tell us exactly where those cross the land masses, over?
Yes, they cross just south of the lower part of Mexico, probably through Central America. That is the equatorial band, which we assume to be the intertropical convergence zone. The other band, which is about 30 south, correctly seems to appear to join equator at the far left, or just beyond the horizon on the left edge of Earth, or at least looks like it's going to join it. We don't have an explanation for that banding.
Roger, Neil. Thank you. It also appears that just to the left of the terminator, up in the northern hemisphere, there's a cloud band trending, a gap in the clouds trending northwest, southeast. It appears to us that that comes in about over the northern United States, or perhaps the central United States. Is that about correct, over?
I can see on the monitor the thing you're talking about, but right now I can't get my eye to the window to pick out just where it crosses the shoreline.
Roger. You guys are doing a good job. It's a real steady picture here. Where clarity is excellent. The color, it's the clouds are, the whites are distinct. The rest of it looks like a, to me anyway, on the monitor I'm observing, is a fairly greenish blue, is the way I describe it. Over. It appears that the...
Well, we can't observe, observe much green from the spacecraft.
Roger. On this monitor, the land masses appear to be just a darker a grayish color rather than a brown.
Well, it's true that we do not have the depth of color at this range that we enjoyed at 50,000 miles out. However, the oceans still are a definite blue, and the continents are generally brownish in cast, although it is true that they're tending more toward gray now than they were at the closer ranges.
Roger, 11. We've been, I've just been vectored to another monitor, and sure enough, the browns are coming in a lot more distinctly on the Ida 4 that we have up on our screen in the control center. Over.
Okay, world, hold on to your hat. I'm going to turn you upside down.
That's a pretty good roll there.
That's pretty sloppy, Charlie. Let me try that one again.
You'll never beat out the Thunderbirds. Apollo 11 Houston, that practice did you some good. It's looking a real smooth roll there. Oops, spoke too soon.
All right, making myself seasick doing it, Charlie. I'll just put you back right side up where you belong.
Roger.
You don't get to do that every day.
Houston, could you describe from your view the polar cloud cap appears to us to extend down the western coast of North America. Would you estimate how far it extends down? Over.
fit everybody into the window with UV cameras.
It appears that the cloud cap comes down a little bit below the southern extremity of Alaska.
Roger. We've, 11, we've lost our picture here now. Okay, Apollo 11 Houston, we've got the picture back now.
Unfortunately, we only have one window that has a view of the Earth, and it's filled up with a TV camera, so your view now is probably better than ours is.
Roger, we copy. 11 Houston, if you could comply, we'd like to see some smiling faces up there. If you could give us some interior views, I'm sure everybody'd like to see you, over.
Okay, we'll reconfigure the TV for that.
Roger. Apollo 11 Houston, appears to us that we're seeing a view from outside plus a little of the inside. Appears you've taken the camera away from the left window. Now, over.
That's correct. We're moving it back and reconfiguring for interior lighting.
Roger. We can still see the Earth through the left window, and it appears that we can see a floodlight off to the left, either that or some sun shafting through the hatch window.
It's a floodlight.
Gotcha. Now we're coming in. Can't quite make out who that is. That's Big Mike Collins there.
Well, you got a little bit of... Yeah, hello there, sports fans. You got a little bit of me, plus Neil's in the center couch, and Buzz is doing the camera work this time.
Roger, it's a little dark now, 11. Maybe a bigger f-stop might help.
Yeah, that didn't work.
It's getting a lot better now, 11. Mike, you're coming in flyby. I got a good...
Well, I put on a coat and tie if I'd known about this ahead of time.
Is Buzz holding your cue cards for you, over?
Cue cards have a no. We have no intention of competing with the professionals, believe me. We are very comfortable up here, though. We do have a happy home. There's plenty of room for the three of us, and I think we're all learning to find our favorite little corner to sit in. Zero G is very comfortable, but after a while you get to the point where you sort of get